They said it was too slow. They said it looked too ugly. Yet here we are over four decades later, and the A-10 Thunderbolt II is still rocking the battlefield like no other aircraft in the United States Air Force inventory. Ladies and gentlemen, feast your eyes on the legendary Warthog, an old-school brawler that refuses to retire, confounding expectations and outliving every obituary the experts try to write for it. But the real question is, what keeps this beast flying? And how do the pilots and ground troops actually feel about having an aircraft designed explicitly around one of the most powerful cannons on Earth? Stick around, because by the end of this video, you'll find out exactly why the Warthog is truly in a league of its own, and will even reveal a surprising technological twist that could extend its life further than anybody ever imagined. Stay tuned until the end, because the most astonishing discovery about this plane, something that even the most seasoned engineers have been quietly marveling at, will be revealed later in this video. Let's wind the clock back to the 1970s. The Vietnam War underscored a glaring issue. High-performance jets were fantastic for air-to-air combat, but not so great for supporting ground troops in the thick of battle. What the Air Force needed was an aircraft capable of loitering over a target, taking a serious beating, and delivering unstoppable firepower. And so, the A-10 Thunderbolt II was born. Nicknamed the Warthog, it didn't win any beauty pageants. But you know what? It didn't need to. Did you know? The A-10 is built around the GAU-8A Avenger cannon, which is nearly as long as a VW Beetle. You heard that right.
Here are the rounds right here. So this is the casing for the round. And these are actually, they stay within the gun, because if you were to spit these out, like a lot of times other guns will.
The plane's entire frame was basically designed around a 30mm 7-barrel Gatling gun that fires at a mind-blowing rate of up to 3,900 rounds per minute. Imagine an angry chainsaw spitting depleted uranium shells the size of soda bottles. Now imagine that in the sky, leveling tanks and ripping through armored columns. That's the A-10's calling card, and it's about as subtle as a sledgehammer in a mirror shop. When the A-10 rolled out, its rugged design raised eyebrows. The twin tail fins, the enormous straight wings, the elevated engines high above the fuselage, it's all carefully orchestrated to help the Warthog survive direct enemy hits and keep on flying. The pilot sits in a titanium bathtub, a protective shell that can sustain hits from ground fire up to 23 millimeters. That means while other jets might go down with a single well-placed shot, the A-10 can literally keep its pilot alive after multiple hits. But here's something they didn't predict. This plane's no-frills design would prove so invaluable on the battlefield that its operational lifespan keeps getting extended, time and time again. We'll dive into why that keeps happening in just a few minutes. The A-10's moment in the spotlight arrived during Operation Desert Storm. Flying over 8,000 sorties, these Warthogs laid waste to the Iraqi Army's tank divisions, radar sites, and convoys. But it wasn't just about firepower, it was about staying power. This plane could circle a battlefield like a hawk, flying low and slow, ready to swoop in at a moment's notice. Ground forces adored it. Enemy forces? Not so much. After all, it's never fun when you hear that distinctive BRRRT of the GAU-8 shelling your position. Speaking of which, did you know that the recoil from the A-10's cannon is so powerful that if fired continuously, it could technically slow the aircraft's forward motion? The engines more than compensate, but the recoil is no joke, like an airborne sledgehammer. In subsequent conflicts, Kosovo, Afghanistan, Iraq, the A-10 hammered bunkers, cave complexes, and insurgent hideouts. Pilots often recounted miraculous stories of limping back to base with one engine, half a tail, or giant holes in their wings. That robust design, once ridiculed for being too ugly, proved to be a lifesaver many times over. Now, if you follow defense news, you've heard this story before. The A-10 is on the chopping block, says the Air Force. Each time, eyebrows are raised, and each time, the Warthog somehow escapes the hangar graveyard. Why? Because while next-gen jets like the F-35 or advanced drones can handle diverse missions, none of them replicate the exact loiter time, the low-speed maneuverability, and that psychologically intimidating GAU-8 cannon.
It fires approximately 3,900 rounds a minute. First, second of fire, fires approximately 50 rounds a second, and then from there it accelerates up to 70 rounds a second.
In close air support, intangible factors often make the difference. Troops on the ground want to see that Warthog overhead, knowing it won't just zoom by once and disappear. The A-10 can circle, patient, watchful, unstoppable. But here's a twist. The Air Force might not keep the A-10 around forever. Or will it? Stick around, because we'll explore a new upgrade package that might ensure the Warthog's future in ways you never saw coming. Before we dig deeper, if you're enjoying this ride through the A-10's storied past and future, take a quick second to hit that like button and subscribe for more insights on cutting-edge military tech. We'd love to hear from you. What new technology do you think will revolutionize warfare? Drop your prediction in the comments below, and we might feature it in an upcoming video. Let's talk about one of the biggest reasons the A-10 might keep defying retirement: the re-winging program. The Air Force has been replacing the aging wings on older A-10s with brand new ones, effectively extending their service life for years. Some say even into the 2030s. Along with the wings, there are upgraded avionics, improved communication systems, and enhanced sensors that boost the Warthog's situational awareness. It's like giving your grandfather's hot rod a brand new engine and high-tech GPS. Still the same classic style, but now it can go the extra mile and keep pace with the modern world. But that's not the end of the line. The A-10 is also evolving to handle a wider variety of ordnance. We're talking precision-guided bombs, Maverick missiles, and advanced targeting pods that turn this low-flying slugger into a sharpshooter. The classic 30mm cannon is still front and center. Don't worry about that. But having the option to strike from farther out and with more precision is a game changer. It's common to compare the A-10 with modern multi-role fighters like the F-15, F-16, or the futuristic F-35. Sure, they can all carry bombs, they can all shoot missiles, but there's one thing the A-10 does that these jets can't replicate with the same gusto: close air support with an absolute dedication to sticking around the battlefield. An F-35 may be stealthy, an F-15 may be lightning fast, but neither can crawl at low altitude for extended periods, literally babysitting ground forces during intense firefights. The Warthog's entire identity is built around that mission. Its armor, its gun, and its cockpit layout are all optimized for that singular purpose: to protect the troops. That's precisely why Army and Marine Corps leaders often vouch for keeping the A-10 around. By the way, we're inching closer to revealing an astonishing potential development that might keep the Warthog in the skies longer than you think. Don't go anywhere. Here it is, the eyebrow-raising concept that's quietly circulating in defense circles. What if the A-10 Thunderbolt II becomes a key platform for coordinating small, autonomous drone swarms? Picture this, the Warthog, with its extended loiter time and robust power supply, commanding a flock of drones that scout enemy positions, jam radars, or even carry out minor strikes, all while the A-10 hovers overhead, ready to deliver that finishing blow if needed. Can you imagine the synergy? A single A-10 controlling multiple unmanned vehicles, saturating an area with sensors and potential weapons. It sounds like science fiction, but in an era where drone technology is advancing at breakneck speed, it's not far-fetched. The Warthog's slower pace could actually benefit drone coordination, allowing it to act as a persistent mobile command post in the sky. Talk about turning a flying cannon into a next-gen battlefield orchestrator. If this project bears fruit, the A-10 might not only stay relevant, it could become a cutting-edge asset, ironically bridging the gap between old-school brute force and new-age autonomy. One aspect that often gets overlooked is morale. When you're pinned down by enemy fire, hearing that iconic BRRRT can lift spirits and change the tide of battle. Soldiers and Marines repeatedly talk about the A-10 as if it's an angel swooping in. It's not just about raw firepower, it's about reassurance. Knowing a pilot with a tried and true machine is up there scanning for threats. The Warthog is more than a plane, it's a guardian. It's that big brother who might not be as flashy as the star quarterback, but when you need muscle and reliability, you know exactly who to call. So, will this old beast ever actually retire? The Air Force has made multiple attempts to move on, focusing on futuristic jets and flexible stealth platforms. But every time Congress steps in or combat commanders speak up, arguing that the Warthog is indispensable. In fact, there's speculation that certain upgraded Warthogs could remain operational well into the 2030s or even 2040, depending on budgets and emerging threats. Considering the first A-10 flew in the mid-1970s, that's a staggering half century of service. So there you have it, the unstoppable, unshakable A-10 Thunderbolt II. It's the plane that was too ugly to love, yet too lovable to let go. A flying cannon that's earned a seat in the pantheon of legendary American aircraft? The question now is, where do you see this beast going next? Will advanced drone integration make it unstoppable? Will the Air Force finally retire it for good? Or is the Warthog simply destined to keep surprising us all? If you found this video insightful, hit that like button and subscribe for more deep dives into modern military marvels. Also, don't forget to weigh in with your thoughts. What new technology do you think will reshape the battlefield? Comment below, we'd love to hear your take. Thanks for watching, and remember, the next time you see that signature silhouette cruising across the sky, keep your head down, because that legendary BRRRT might just be your saving grace.